Don't worry. I will get it back.
Wherever he goes, and so desperately wants to share that positivity, even with those who don't want it. Now, throughout the series, he has been arrested 7 times, mainly for theft and being a public nuisance, and even Santa called him a menace in spite of his good nature, which kind of summarizes him perfectly. None of this negativity is intentional, though. SpongeBob doesn't have a bad bone in his body.
Thanks for the lies, Mr. Fairy Tail!
Well, as a sponge, he doesn't really have any bones, but he just simply doesn't have the self-awareness to know when he's doing harm. His treatment of Squidward is usually born from wanting to make him happy, and in a lot of ways, he represents a hedonistic pursuit of fun. Despite mostly liking him, the residents of Bikini Bottom find his antics annoying, so much so that in the episode Gone, they organize a national No SpongeBob Day that even Patrick takes part in.
A whole day dedicated to getting away from you!
His games also have a habit of going way too far, such as when he tricked a lifeguard into thinking that he was dying, or when he sabotaged Squidward so he could become the employee of the month.
You can't win that award if you don't get up for work!
Or when he made fun of Sandy for not being able to do everything that the underwater creatures could. There's definitely a small villainous side to our favorite sponge. He helped Mr. Krabs poison a health inspector, tortured Patrick on a number of occasions, and once shrunk the entire town, and kept them in a jar. He may be fun, exciting, and the star of the show, but SpongeBob certainly isn't a saint. He should still be your first port of call in Bikini Bottom, though. He means well.
Created for the sole purpose of protecting the Earth from danger, from giant monsters and crazy villains, to natural disasters and killer asteroids, Jenny does her job almost perfectly.
Bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Though there are times where she wishes she could be a normal teenager, she still cares about her job as a superhero, and will always do whatever it takes to save the day, even if it means swallowing her pride or sacrificing her social life. When humans frustrate her or discriminate against her, she never tries to do them any harm, despite having more than enough power to do so. Though she is a robot and being a hero is in her programming, we feel that Jenny shows enough sentience and independence that her choices are her own and not ones made by code. Especially when you take in the fact that she isn't always perfect. In the episode Girl of Steel, Jenny resorts to stealing an expensive music player, disguising herself as Ruby Rocket so that she doesn't ruin her reputation. She comes clean in the end to prevent her mother from taking the blame.
All I ever wanted was to fit in, to be one of you.
Her occasional self-consciousness can sometimes blind her, and she also seems to have a temper when pushed too far, like when Sheldon refused to give her space, or when kindergartners went and stopped picking on her. But even after...
And when I do, oh yes, you'll pay. I swear, by all that is... corn. I swear!